I spent the last 2 weeks thinking how I would find something that linked all the people of this group, all the people of this church, and so many more than that here. I failed miserably. It was definitely not my pay grade. There's not any one thing that I could come up with that made this so special to us all. One thing that I do know, though, that for all of us that knew this, the thing that we will probably remember forever is that we always smiled around him and that we were always happy. And it's a great way to remember, it's a great way to think of anyone. So, having failed miserably philosophically, I had to fall back onto my personal relationship with this. And as I said, my list, I like a lot of those wonderful things that we shared. When I met Des, I was the laziest sales rep at an airline in Australia. And somehow I got an interview with Des to join Amex. It was an interesting gig. He made me feel very relaxed. He became so relaxed that I'm fairly certain he had a little sleep in between the interview. But I've never been sure of that, but he was fairly horizontal and not asking too many questions. So after about a week or so of working in American Express and learning all the things that I had tried to learn, all the things that I needed to know about a completely different operation than being a sales rep, I had some time with this, and I said, now with this, what do you want me to do in this first year? And he said, well, the first thing I'd like you to do is to double the turnover. Well, I don't know if any of you have ever had somebody say, just double the turnover in a year, but I hadn't heard it before. And if anyone else from this, I would have laughed. But you know, I didn't. It just seemed like a reasonable request. That was the sort of control he had over people. It was. And the thing that I didn't actually realise then, during that year, was it wasn't as hard as I thought, because if I had a hard person trying to confirm them as an account of American Express, I simply invited him into Des's office to meet him. We always came out of the deal. It was just like that. The other one was even better. Looking back, the 200% increase in the turnover seemed easy to recovering a whole bunch of money that a very well-known business, headed by a gentleman whose name I shouldn't say here, had managed to rack up with the travel division of Amex. And this called me for one of my second real challenges, I guess. And he said, this person owes us X amount of money, which would be hundreds and hundreds of thousands of dollars now, and he's not even taking our phone calls to recover it. And he said, I want you to go down and get money. And right, that was exactly what I was talking about. And I said, well, there's, I don't have a lot of, you know, information to go on. I have no way of understanding how you can get a man like this to pay. He said, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. You'll figure it out on the way down. I was straight out the door, and I can remember walking down to this meeting thinking, what do I need? A baseball bat? Do I go in and threaten with a lawyer? Anyway, whatever it was, something that would give me the confidence to go into this man, sit in his office and not leave until I came out with the money. And I did. And that was the first time that I realized that Des had more confidence in the people around him than perhaps we had in ourselves. And it was a real turning point for me. Within weeks of that period, I met June and the kids for the first time. And after that evening, your place is in court. I knew that I was part of the Willem clan, and it was an extended clan. It was this vote. This sounds like something that is hard to write from my own memories and my own building, my own confidence, but it all relates back to this, as Martin said. I just want to be with this, I want to watch him, and I want to listen to him. And I remember after a long day where we'd often be in the office till 7 or 8 o'clock, and we were living in St. Ives, I drive this home to Seaforth, just to spend a little bit more time. I realised that the way that he operated the business was the only model ever made sense to me, and still does. He built people's confidence. He built them around an objective that he shared with them. In fact, he was actually a benign dictator. He knew exactly where he wanted to take us all. And we'd embrace that as almost part of our own vision, and before long, of course, it became a shared vision. And I knew that if I could bring that into my future personality, that it would help me tremendously in American Express. When I saw my future there at the time, the people that Des brought together, and some of them, my friend Bill, my friend Barry, and of course Michael, were all part of that vision. And we all absolutely followed Des's coattails to get to where he wanted to go with all the enthusiasm that we could possibly get out of our own personalities. When Des moved to New York, apart from feeling proud to become a senior vice president, I was alarmed when he was leaving. It was a light, incense going off. But Des's communication was fantastic. We talked all the time, sometimes at 3 a.m. in the morning, often at 3 a.m. in the morning, because when Des wanted to give me a call, he would simply pick up the phone. That got so bad that I had to pull the phone out of the wall at night, because the phone calls did come through at 3 a.m. Then, the question that I had is, how was I going to keep this relationship going, learning from Des and having enough ability to try and do new things that hadn't perhaps been tried yet, just the way that Des had done in Australia. So I suggested to Des that on top of all the things that American Express had achieved, that we should balance our retail operations with our wholesale operation in Singapore, Malaysia, Hong Kong, Taipei, and the Philippines. And it was pretty easy when you get it down. We had the product, and we had the way to do it. It was, again, the relationship between the major carriers of those countries, Singapore Airlines as an example, who would help us propel to success. So within a relatively short time, there were successful businesses. And around about that time, on a trip to New York, I realized that Canada was sitting right up there with 35 million people, right beside the United States. The American Express was doing nothing about that market at all. So I went out to Des and said, look, I really think that, first of all, New York should get into it, and whoever was running that particular part of Des's empire, it was all too hard, they were foreigners, I'll say before it. So I said to Des, well, will you let me have a go? And he said yes. Anyway, within a couple of years, we had a good business there and it turned profitable, and after that, New York saw the need to take it back. What that proved to me, though, was that Des was prepared to give people enough rope to hang themselves. And I don't know any of us that got hung out to dry. We just believe that with his backing and the things that we've learned, we will be successful. Thanks for it was a fabulous feeling. And it stayed with me in my later life when I left American Express and went into my own businesses. Visiting mine was always like going back to the family. The kids were there, we played tennis at the school. It was just another home away from home. Even when I left Amex, and of course Fez was still there, we were traveling up through to the States to see you all regularly. And I don't think we ever lost touch. But when you came back to Australia, you know, I really thought that you would. I always thought that those would come home to you. We have our usual lunches and a couple of glasses of beer, and we ultimately had a game of golf with the only two people in the world who would golf play golf with me by choice, my friend Barry and theirs. Bob has told me to get off here, I'm too long with you. Okay, so Des went to the play golf. The other than the worst golfer in the world, there may be a worse one that hasn't been found yet. And even when I did the odd good shot, he would always be there to encourage me to go further. Even when something went flying off into the distance and he said what a great shot it was, and I looked down and the wall was still there, but the head of the club was going into the bushes about 100 yards away. So, how can I end this without sounding too moral? I guess that's what Des meant to me. He was certainly my mentor. He was certainly my tutor. He was probably the older brother I didn't have. But most of all, he was my friend, and I will always remember.